In part one, we dramatized the so-called surprise exam paradox. A teacher, Mr. Harris, announces to his class that he intends to give them a surprise exam next week on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. In response, a student, Alice, points out that Mr. Harris can't give a surprise exam on Friday, because then on Thursday evening the class would know that the exam would have to be on Friday. So Mr. Harris is forced to concede that the surprise exam can only take place on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. But in that case, by the same logic, an exam on Thursday wouldn't be a surprise, because everyone would then know on Wednesday evening that the exam could only be on Thursday, and so on. Evidently, the teacher can't fulfill the terms of his announcement. He can't give a surprise exam on any of the 5 days. Of course, this conclusion flies in the face of common sense. A surprise exam can happen. For example, we can imagine the exam taking place on Tuesday. If it does, the class will have no way of predicting the exam day beforehand. After all, the exam could just as easily have taken place on Monday, for example, or on Wednesday. How can this paradox be resolved? Where was the flaw in Alice's reasoning? This is Decomplexify, bringing a welcome dose of simplicity to complex topics. We'll start by considering a simple, but ultimately not very satisfactory, approach to resolving the paradox. This approach is to claim that we can never know in advance that an exam is going to take place at all. Sure, Mr. Harris says an exam is going to take place, but how do we know he's right? What if, in the small hours of the morning of Mr. Harris's chosen exam day, the school burns down? In that case, there almost certainly will be no exam that day, nor on any of the remaining days of the week. Once we admit this kind of possibility, we have to admit that even if we get to Thursday evening without an exam, we still don't know what's going to happen on Friday. Maybe the exam will take place on Friday, or maybe the school will burn down before the exam has the chance to take place. Or maybe some other unforeseen event will prevent the exam from happening. Alternatively, maybe Mr. Harris is a liar and never intended to give an exam in the first place. So even the occurrence of an exam on Friday is, in a technical sense, not knowable in advance. And if Friday can't be ruled out as a surprise exam day, then none of the preceding days can be ruled out either. But resolving the paradox in this way feels like sidestepping the problem rather than really confronting it. So instead of making things easy for ourselves, let's assume, for the purposes of the surprise exam scenario, that an exam will definitely take place on one of the 5 days. In fact, while we're at it, we might as well lay down some other ground rules. Let's also assume, for the purposes of this scenario, that the students in the class are justified in believing that the teacher is sincere in his intention to make the exam a surprise. As the days go by, neither the students nor the teacher will forget the content of the announcement, nor will they forget what has happened on previous days. The students are maximally rational, and their powers of deduction are in perfect working order at all times. Let's review how the paradox plays out. A student runs through the days in a backward sequence and thinks, the teacher won't give the exam on Friday, because if he did, we'd be able to predict it on Thursday evening and it wouldn't be a surprise. So really, the last possible day for a surprise exam is Thursday. But then the teacher won't give the exam on Thursday, because if he did, we'd be able to predict it on Wednesday evening and it wouldn't be a surprise. And so on, until it becomes apparent that the teacher can't surprise the class on any of the 5 days. This reasoning needs to be examined more closely. Let's start by reviewing what the student's mindset would be on Thursday evening if an exam had not yet taken place. What would your attitude be in this situation? It is safe to say you would tell yourself that because there is only one possible exam day left, the exam will be on Friday. And because you are able to know with complete confidence that Friday will be the day of the exam, you'll also know that the teacher is going to fail to achieve his aim of giving a surprise exam. Now let us step back a day and ask what your attitude would be on Wednesday evening if an exam had not yet taken place. Would your attitude be A, I still have complete confidence in the teacher's announcement, and I am sure that when the exam does take place, it will be a surprise. B, I no longer believe the teacher can surprise us, and I know that a non-surprise exam will take place on Friday. C, I no longer believe the teacher can surprise us, and I know that a non-surprise exam will take place on Thursday. D, I am unsure whether the teacher will surprise us or not. Let's examine these options one by one. Suppose your attitude is A, I still have complete confidence in the teacher's announcement, and I am sure that when the exam does take place, it will be a surprise. Now, given your belief that the exam will be a surprise, you have to believe that the exam will not take place on Friday, because you know a Friday exam cannot be a surprise exam. With Friday ruled out, your only other option is to believe that the surprise exam will be on Thursday. But believing the surprise exam will be on Thursday makes no sense, because if you're sure the exam will be on Thursday, then it can't be a surprise. Therefore, attitude A is nonsensical, and your attitude on Wednesday evening cannot justifiably be attitude A. Now to attitude B. I no longer believe the teacher can surprise us, and I know that a non-surprise exam will take place on Friday. Having this attitude also makes no sense, because committing yourself to a belief that the exam will be on Friday would mean the teacher could easily surprise you simply by giving the exam on Thursday, and you must know this. Therefore, your attitude on Wednesday evening cannot justifiably be attitude B. What about attitude C? I no longer believe the teacher can surprise us, and I know that a non-surprise exam will take place on Thursday. The relevant question here is, what makes you so sure a non-surprise exam will take place on Thursday? Perhaps the teacher will flip a coin to decide between giving an exam on Thursday and giving it on Friday. If the exam day can be decided by a coin flip, then there is simply no way that you can know in advance that the exam will be on Thursday. And if you're convinced that such a coin flip can't occur, why are you convinced? You yourself believe at this point that all hope of having a surprise exam has been lost. And if you believe this, it seems entirely possible that the teacher could believe this. With no hope left of a surprise, the teacher is entitled to regard Thursday and Friday as equally bad options, and a coin flip is as good a way as any of deciding between them. So attitude C cannot be sustained either. Attitudes A, B, and C were all attitudes of certainty. Since none of them can be sustained, the only attitude that is justifiable on Wednesday evening is attitude D. I am unsure whether the teacher will surprise us or not. So let's summarize. On Wednesday evening, if no exam has taken place yet, you will be left unsure whether the teacher is going to manage to make the exam a surprise or not. Therefore, on Wednesday evening, there is simply no predicting what the teacher is going to do. And in particular, there is no way to rule out the possibility of a Thursday exam. This gives us a way out of the paradox. It points us to a flaw in the supposed proof that a surprise exam can't take place on any of the 5 days. The crucial step in the supposed proof was the step that said that the exam couldn't possibly take place on Thursday, on the grounds that if it did, then on Wednesday evening the student would be able to predict it. What we have just seen is that on Wednesday evening the student would not be able to predict it, because on Wednesday evening the student would be in a state of uncertainty about whether the teacher really was going to succeed in surprising the class or not. And so, the logic that says Thursday can be ruled out is flawed. One of the lessons here is that just because we're justified in believing something right now doesn't mean we would continue to be justified in believing it if time passed and the situation changed. And so, we're done. Or are we? It's true that we've succeeded in showing that a student, when thinking through the surprise exam scenario, isn't justified in concluding that a surprise exam is impossible. But in the situation we presented initially, the Alice and Mr. Harris scenario, Alice wasn't thinking through the scenario all on her own. Instead, she was getting her teacher to agree with every step in her logic. Her teacher, Mr. Harris, found himself admitting first that he couldn't give a surprise exam on Friday, then that he couldn't give it on Thursday, then that he couldn't give it on Wednesday, and so on, until it appeared to him that he couldn't give a surprise exam at all. So the question becomes, how could Mr. Harris have avoided making these admissions? What could he have said to Alice other than what he did say? The answer flows out of our earlier observation that on Wednesday evening, the student would be uncertain as to whether the teacher really was going to succeed in surprising the class or not. Let's rewind to the moment Alice uttered the following words to Mr. Harris. "There's no way you can give us an exam on Friday and have it be a surprise, is there?" Here is what Mr. Harris could have said to Alice in response. "It's true that the exam is going to be a surprise, so yes, it's true that I won't give the exam on Friday. But despite these things being true, if we get to Wednesday evening without an exam, then you will no longer be sure that they're true." And now the process of ruling out successively earlier days, Thursday, Wednesday, etc., is blocked. Alice is unable to get Mr. Harris to rule out Thursday as an exam day because Mr. Harris insists, rightly, that after 3 days without an exam, the class would be in a state of uncertainty about the validity of his announcement, and that under these circumstances, a Thursday exam could surprise them. This really does wrap it up for the surprise exam paradox. Does the solution presented in this video make sense to you? And do you agree that it resolves the paradox? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. And let us know in the comments if there are other complex topics you'd like to see addressed on Decomplexify. Feel free to like, subscribe, or share. So long, and thanks for watching.